Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My today's topic is Abhili for the students of class 10th. Dear students, in this lesson you will learn all about the short story. The short story is entitled Abhili. Abhili actually is the main character of the short story. She can be well termed as the heroine of the short story. Abhili represents simplicity and old age. This short story also throws light on generation gap. Generation gap is considered as the tussle between old and young. Before reading the lesson, let me explain the meanings of some new words. The first word is chop. It means to cause, to stop breathing. Next one is sanki. Sanki means full of water or covered with water. Kajol means motivate or pursue. Apprehensive means fearing or showing fear. Abhili means grandmother. I request you all, please keep open your textbook. And I hope that after watching this video, you all will read the short story from beginning to end. I am going to read the general summary of the short story. Abhili is an old grandmother. She lives in a remote area of Ladakh. Her granddaughter Roxana studies in Srinagar. One day Abhili hears that an earthquake has hit Turkey. She began scolding her sons for sending Roxana to Srinagar. She prays and weeps for Roxana's safety. All the other family members try to make her understand that Turkey is very far away from Srinagar, but it was not possible for them to cajole her. Cajole means to motivate or to pursue. She was worried about Roxana since the evening Roxana departed to Srinagar. When Abhili heard that the bus in which her granddaughter was traveling had broken down near Kargil, she argued that Roxana had not survived. Dear students, breakdown is a compound word. It means the condition of a vehicle or machine when it stops working. Abhili thought that the bus might have broken into pieces. Whenever she heard any news about any accident or any other incident of firing or any other issue, she triggered a series of questions. Is my Roxana safe? Was Roxana traveling in that bus? Was Roxana walking on the road when the firing started? One day, the narrator's uncle had put his hunting gun in one of the rooms. Abhili guarded the room until the narrator's uncle returned. She didn't allow any child to touch the gun. She was of the opinion that as soon as the gun was touched, the bullets would explode and they all would die. The narrator, Abdulgiri Sheikh, says that he got advantage of Abhili's innocence. The army of children always present at home used to tear his notebooks to make kites and paper boats. One day, the narrator told Abhili that those papers were official. From that day, she preserved all his papers. No child would dare to look at them. She also preserved the papers from the snip seller, thinking that they were all official papers. One day, Abhili was taken to cinema.
to see a Philip. So from then on, whenever anyone mentioned the film, Abeli would rebuking all mother-in-law. One day, a neighboring Abi told Abeli that there were severe floods in Srinagar. Abeli began weeping for Roxana. And another incident, Dolma was one of their relatives' daughter. She lived in Delhi. One day, she visited the narrator's house. Abeli didn't recognize her because of her modern dress and outlook. She called her Amin Sal. When she learned that she wasn't any Meme Saab but Dolma, she asked her where she lived. Dolma answered that she lived in Delhi. Oh, then you must be meeting Roxana every day, Abeli said to her with a smile. Dear students, now let me explain the themes of the short story Abeli. The short story revolves around three grand themes. Number one, tradition versus modernity. Number two, simplicity and innocence. Number three, generation gap. पहला theme जो short story का है वो है tradition versus modernity. Abeli एक बूढ़ी खातून थी. She was an old lady. She was totally unaware about modern technology. She used to call radio as rildri. She thought that the world is just like his small village. She didn't know that Turkey is thousands of miles far from Srinagar and Delhi is far from Srinagar. She asked Dolma if she was meeting Roxana every day. इसका मतलब है कि उसे ये खबर नहीं थी कि श्रीनगर और दिल्ली में बहुत फर्क है. Second theme of the short story is simplicity and innocence. Abeli was very simple and she was innocent. और ये जो simple और innocent लोग होते हैं, कभी कभार बाकी लोग उनका उनसे फायदा हासिल करते हैं. जिस तरह से नरेटर ने कहा कि ही गॉट एडवांटेज ऑफ Abeli, नरेटर ने Abeli से कहा कि बच्चे जो पेपर्स वगैरह काटते हैं ये ऑफिशियल पेपर्स हैं, तो Abeli सारे कागजात जो भी उसे मिलते थे प्रिजर्व करके रखती थी. दुकान से जो मिर्च हल्दी नस्वार या बाकी चीजें जो लाते हैं कागजों में, वो उन कागजों को भी प्रिजर्व करके रखती थी और समझती थी कि ये ऑफिशियल पेपर्स ही. द थर्ड एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थीम ऑफ द शॉर्ट स्टोरी इज जनरेशन गैप. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय जनरेशन गैप? जनरेशन गैप मीन्स द डिफरेंस इन बिहेवियर टुवर्ड्स समथिंग. इन आवर सोसाइटी देयर इज ऑलवेज tussle between grandparents and grandchildren. Their ideologies are different. हमारे बुजुर्ग लोग समझते हैं कि जो नौजवान हैं ये गलत हैं, लेकिन नौजवान समझते हैं कि हमारे बुजुर्ग लोग गलत हैं. अगर हम देखेंगे कि दोनों अपनी अपनी जगह पर सही हैं. बुजुर्ग लोग चाहते हैं कि जिस तरीके से हमने जिंदगी गुजारी है, जो आज के बच्चे ही ये भी उसी तरह की जिंदगी गुजारे. बट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. उस वक्त अगर गाड़ी नहीं थी वो पैदल चलते थे, लेकिन आज गाड़ी है तो गाड़ी का इस्तेमाल करना है. और जो बुजुर्ग ही जो हमें नसीहत करते हैं, हम उसको गलत तरीके से या गलत अंदाज से समझते हैं. हमें ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए. सो वी बोथ आर राइट. सो वी ऑल शुड अंडरस्टैंड वन एनदर. हमें एक दूसरे के साथ तजाद नहीं करना चाहिए. आमतौर से घरों में भी
मसले पैदा हो जाते हैं छोटे और बड़ों में, हमेशा से तजाद पैदा हो जाते हैं, उन तजादों को खत्म करने के लिए हम सबको काम करना चाहिए। तो जनरेशन गैप वो गैप होती है, वो फासला होता है जो एक जनरेशन और दूसरी जनरेशन के दरमियान होता है। आई विल टीच यू मोर अबाउट दिस शॉर्ट स्टोरी इन सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो।